There's a story that you have uncovered out of High Point, a gentleman named Willis Hinton. Tell us about him.
Yeah, he's a fascinating figure. One of the things that I wanted to do in writing about the African-American entrepreneurial history or the story of African-American entrepreneurs is to include some of the smaller businessmen and women, not necessarily the one who makes, you know, millions and millions of dollars, more on like the common individual, because I think many lessons can be learned from that as well. Well, Willis Hinton was a slave. He moved to High Point after he gained his freedom in 1865 to work on the North Carolina Railroad. He did so. He was laying tracks, railroad ties, etc. And he had a dream to own a business. So he starts saving his money, and he opens a cafe, and that's successful. And then he's still saving his money from the profits that he's making from the cafe, and he opened an 11-room hotel, which he operated until the day he died. So, as I mentioned before, I consider him an entrepreneurial success, not on the level of C.C. Spaulding or John Merrick or Dr. Aaron Moore of Durham, but here is a man who was a slave, adapted quickly after slavery to his freedom, saved his money, opened businesses, and he did so during the era of Jim Crow.
What can we learn from some of these stories of success during really, really difficult times?
Well, during these difficult times, all of these entrepreneurial examples, they were ambitious folks, but coupled with ambition, you combine it with thrift and with drive, determination, hard work, and that led to their success. It's really it's an easy recipe to spell out. Sometimes it's more difficult to live out.